It's only been a year since I really started on the laser journey, and man, lasers have changed so much just in the past year. I'm actually really surprised to see how accessible lasering has become. I've gone from seeing diode lasers that are basically things you have to put together yourself and fine-tune, to having all-inclusive laser systems such as the WeCreat Vision, which is the laser I'm going to be talking about today.
The WeCreat Vision is a fully enclosed 20-watt diode laser, which is plenty for most projects. Its max speed is 600 millimeters per second and has a precision of 0.01 millimeters. While it supports project-sized panels, the working area is 420 by 290 millimeters. It comes ready to tackle rotary engraving, great for tumblers, but also isn't a requirement if you don't want to buy into that feature. Most of this is pretty standard stuff, but what really makes the WeCreat stand out is the auto-lift feature. You have up to 140 millimeters of wiggle room for thicker materials and engravable objects, because the machine will quite literally self-expand to fit the materials. Thanks to the built-in high-definition camera, you also have an accurate preview of the material bed, and it will give you autofocus.
And consequently, this is a video where you learn exactly how short I am, because as soon as I turned on the WeCreat Vision after setting everything up, it raised up like this, and that's the door. But don't be fooled. There's a lot going on with this little machine. So I didn't show an unboxing video because I figured YouTube does not need yet another unboxing video of this particular machine. So it basically comes with a couple of samples of 3 millimeter basswood. It also had these tests that were inside so it can show you exactly what the machine is capable of doing and that they tested it prior to packaging. I thought that was actually pretty darn cool. Next, it also comes with the rotary unit. It is in two pieces and it is a little less on the build quality side than I'm used to seeing, but I typically don't use rotaries except for on my larger machine, which is a ginormous industrial CO2 laser. So for what this is, it's awesome because you will actually be able to use the chuck rotary style, which I find easier for tumblers. I will be doing a separate video on tumblers and how to use rotary systems, because that is its own like whole thing. Next, it does have the air assist, and this is basically what's giving you the air assist. It is a tiny little compressor, and so while the machine is running, you'll hear this, but since it's on little like rubber things, it's actually not that loud. I did a couple of test engravings and cuts prior to filming, of course, and I barely heard it. I'll go ahead and I'll just state outright that I am fairly experienced with lasers now from all different types. But this is the easiest setup that I have ever had, and the first time that I've actually gotten a manual that was easy to follow. At no point did I find any confusion with any of the steps, including setting it up on my Wi-Fi network, which it's running off of now. Otherwise, you would see me like this with a laptop. I also want to point out that I do have the fume purifier system that comes with the machine only if you buy it with a purification bundle. It is an additional cost otherwise. That said, it does actually come with two additional filters. These are the pre-filters that go in the upper layer here. One of the unique things you may have noticed already about the WeCreat Vision is that it can raise and lower. This section right here allows the machine to raise the laser head higher or lower to give you more room to work with larger items. This is something that I cannot do without manually lifting up one of those open gantry lasers, and it's a little wobbly and not terribly safe. And my CO2 laser can do that, but that's a $10,000 CO2 that I don't think anybody normally has room for in their home. So of course, since it has mobile parts to it other than the laser head itself, I want to emphasize it's built very well. I'm gonna knock it again because it's metal. I mean, it's all metal, it's not plastic, except for the top here. So let's take a look at the inside of the machine. Whee! Clunk. I like making space noises with my mouth. I found it easier to put the beds in after I had first turned on the machine and allowed it to raise up, which is the first thing it's going to do when it's powered on for the first time. Now if we back it out again, space. Now take a look right here. This is where you're gonna plug in the rotary system. And again, that's something that I will go through in a separate video. Like I said, rotary is its own thing. Moving on to look at the hood here. It is already in a laser safe viewing mode acrylic that is available right there. And you do have limit switches that are all over the lid to ensure that the machine will pause or outright cut off if it's get lifted while it's running. There is also a built-in camera that will let you accurately place things inside the machine. And I gotta say, I didn't have to calibrate it. There are calibration options, but this was accurate right out of the gate for me. Oh, and because I have to say it, please have a fire extinguisher available to you in your laser space at all times. So you might be wondering about size, because this is a little smaller looking than the ones that I've shown in the past with other videos and reviews. Well, I'm happy to say that the bed size itself can fit these project panels. A project panel is basically 12 inches tall and 20 inches wide. A lot of suppliers will now have those size boards available to people who have smaller lasers. Now, before you go supply shopping, make sure you remember this is a diode laser. It's not gonna be able to mark all of those cute glitter and mirror and clear acrylics that you might wanna use. It can, however, work with some solid acrylics, specifically black acrylic. If you have no idea what I'm talking about with it being a diode versus a CO2 or a fiber laser, I got a video for that. So let's talk about the software options. All lasers are going to need some kind of software package to help communicate with it and drive the laser. It's only recently that a lot of laser companies have adopted making their own software instead of telling everybody to go get LaserGerbil or Lightburn. Those are two excellent programs that are available to you should you want to use them. However, they kind of require you to understand lasers in general. So if you're just wanting to get started and you don't want to have to fuss around with settings or worry about the more advanced features of a laser, don't worry, they have their own software. So let's take a moment to actually demonstrate the camera. I think the camera, apart from the other aspects of software and other things that kind of make this more accessible for people, is the most important feature. Now you can figure out where to accurately place your design without having to finagle with creating a jig. So the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna go ahead and open this up. And this is where I said that you're gonna see exactly how short I am. I have to get on my tippy toes. And I'm just gonna place this keychain in here on the knife bed, okay? Then I'll close the lid. And we'll go to the software. So when you first go into the software and you start it up and you connect to your laser, you're not gonna see anything there because you need to actually refresh the camera. You just click the refresh button and it will basically take another photo to give you that view. And there we have our keychain. Now, keychains are one thing, and as a bag maker, I love to use keychains to kind of toss in with the packages for people who purchase bags, because it's a nice little thank you, and it didn't cost me a whole lot to make. But what if you want to add more options to your business and not just use that as a way to like give something to a customer? Well, let's do an actual project for a door hanger, because I don't know about y'all, but every time I am in a meeting, somebody bothers me, so I need something on my door that says, please don't come in here, there be dragons. So I've already put down the 3mm basswood that they had provided with the machine as sample material, and refreshed the camera so I can see it here. And I'm gonna go to the upload button, and I don't think it's actually uploading for what it's worth, I think it's just called upload. And I created the door hanger design in Adobe Illustrator. So that's why you can see the different color lines already in place, is because I did that export from Illustrator to an SVG file. I can basically select everything now and move it into position so that I don't waste any materials. Also, order does matter. So I'm gonna go here and drop down all of the different colors. So red is for cut, black is for engrave, and then green is basically a score line that I like to do after the fact. It just helps make text pop. So I'm gonna select the black here and we're gonna do a fill engrave. And I'm actually going to use the guide here in the preview to give me an idea what I want. And so if I want, I can actually go really slowly with a high power and get that nice dark engrave, or I could go lighter. If you're going to be staining something like this, then you can go a little lighter because the stain's going to help bring that color out anyway. So for me, I'm gonna go middle of the road, probably right here, 150 with 60% power, and it automatically sets it for me so I can drop that preview. And then we'll click on the score lines and we're just going to do engrave. Now, so you know, engrave does mean scoring here, and then fill engrave is for the fill. I'm gonna take this down a notch, probably to 35% and 200 speed, because sometimes doing these score lines with a, you know, speed like that, it can really mess up the y-axis on these machines, so I just don't like to go too fast when I'm doing a score. Once I think I've got everything ready to go, I'm gonna click on autofocus and let it do its thing. Cool, so it's done the autofocus, which is basically making sure that everything is good for the laser and the distance from its material. Again, that's really important for these lasers. So it's basically using its little red dot to ensure that it's not too far away or too close to that material. So I have everything ready to go. This design's gonna take 10 minutes, so I am gonna time-lapse speed up everything just for the sake of your sanity. This turned out really well. I'm gonna hold it up. Look at that. That is awesome. Thank you so much for paying attention. Feel free to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave your comments and questions in the comment section below. As always, happy crafting.